We go, and we're back again. Whey! Let's continue. Right, so we wanted to fast travel to the sink balcony, but that caused it to crash. Can't fast travel when enemies are nearby. Ah, poo.
Time to fight.
Ooh, 75 caps. Man, I'm picking up a lot of cash. Probably already looked at this one. Finance clipboard, who cares? Boo hoo. Robo brain. Can't be asked to fight you, mate. I'm off. I'm heading back to... Oh! Crappins. Are you friendly? No, he's fucking not, and nor is his auto dog. Military cyber dog. This is bad. Oh, I'm not sure that's going to happen. What the hunky chunks happened there? Alright, everybody calm down. I can kill you all, but not if you start mobbing me like this. Right, do we attack the military cyber dog? Or the police cyber dog? Well, I think a headshot... Followed by a headshot, we'll probably finish that one off. Okay, that's one. There's the military dog down. Let's just quickly get behind this rubble. And reload. Reloading in rubble. It's what I like to do. Goodbye, Robo Brain, and a little extra bullet. Good evening, Singor. When you enter the tavern, the locals fall silent. When you kick, it hits ass. Enemies flee in fear at the sound of your clacking concrete testicles as you stride towards them. You are Singor. Hail Singor. All cower in awe. There you go. How do you like that? A little bit of a reading for you. Dog hide, dog meat. We'll have it. Let's have some ancient cyber dog meat. Because if you think about it, these cyber dogs were made before the apocalypse, at least 200 years ago. So the flesh on them is 200 year old. There's food for thought, right? I bet you'd never considered that before. I bet your cogitations had never traversed that topology. Oh my goodness, what's happening to me? I'm speaking like a madman. Oh, well, thank you very much. Spectacular indeed. Wow, enemies nearby. Enemies up my bum, that's what I say. Actually, can we fast travel now? Is this available? No, of course not. Am I heading the right direction, generally speaking? Ah, just head for the dome. That'll be the ticket. I'll loot this little case. Oh, there's another one over there. This whole area is absolutely riddled with little safe boxes. Oh, danger's flashing. Sod it, we'll run. Gun away, let's go. Let us traverse the wasteland at speed. I think the steps are over here. Don't want to get too close to the radioactive waste. That's not going to be a fun encounter. That's going to be a bit of a waste of my time. Oh, what's that over there? Just the light. Ignore it. Ignore the light. Move away from the light, Carolyn! Okay. There's the steps. It's amazing how many cigarettes have survived the apocalypse as well. I mean, I would have thought they'd have spoiled by now. But apparently not. Apparently cigarettes are eternal. Enduring like cockroaches after the apocalypse. Let's go to the sink first and repair the auto dock. Tum ti tum, doo de doo, da de da. Where are you? Ah, there you are.
Well, how about that? Old auto dock's back online. Well, alright, come here, let's have a look at you. Well, he ain't the fittest horse that ever ran a race, but he don't appear in immediate danger of keeling over. I can patch you up if you want.
I'd like to engage your services. Can you do anything beyond healing me? I'm feeling a little unwell in the head. Can you perform a psychiatric evaluation on me? I don't need anything right now. Okay, let's start with, can you do anything beyond healing me?
Well, firstly, I would say providing wholeness of the body is service enough, but if you must know, I'm also programmed with cosmetical subroutines. Diagnostic says they're offline at the moment, though. Something about corrupted data files and all manner of such foolishness. If you want a haircut or a nose job that won't leave you looking like a ghoul with alopecia, you'll have to find replacement discs for them. Also, and I won't swear to this, but I recollect at some point having a few implant installation modules. Can't speak to where they got to, though.
Fair enough. I think I might have had them, though. I'd like to engage your services.
And rightly so, I should think. All right, then. Let me just fire up the old interface for you.
What have we got here? Prototype Autodoc. This prototype autodoc is capable of performing a thorough physical exam and curing the patient of all common ailments. Radiation sickness, lacerations, broken bones, even chemical addictions. Yes! In addition, it can also give haircuts and perform cosmetic surgery. Let's have a basic physical exam, please.
Three angry death claws make for a lot of reconstructions.
I am now completely healthy. This implant C13 is now available for surgical installation. Nice. Implant Y3 is now available for surgical installation.
You require some additional services?
I'd like to know about your implants.
I'm feeling a little unwell in the head. Can you perform a psychiatric evaluation on me?
Concerned about the state of your mind, are you? Well, such things ain't my specialty, but I'm happy to tender my opinion as to your mental health. I should make you aware that the benefits of such a procedure are exclusive. That is, this only works once. Now, are you sure this is what you want?
On second thought, not now.
Well, I'll be right here if you change your mind.
I think what that allows me to do is change my stats.
You require some additional services?
I'd like to engage your services.
Rightly so, I should think. All right, then. Let me just fire up the old interface for you.
Okay, so I've had the basic physical exam. I don't want cosmetic surgery or a haircut, but I think I will install my implants. Okay, what do we got? Perform surgery to install cybernetic implants. Do nothing, install implant C13 plus 10 Cazador damage. 8,000 caps? Up your bum. I've not even seen a Cazador. Install implant Y3, drinking radiation removed. 12,000 caps. I genuinely don't care about either of these, and they're so expensive. Let's do nothing. That's a good point. I could save. Yes. Quick save and see. Let's do nothing for a sec. Savey wavy. Saving my game, please do. Okay, let's have a quick look at my stats pre-enhancement. Stats, here we go. 665, 10565. Ooh. Of course, some of those obviously have been enhanced by external forces. Am I still addicted to the doodah, though? Let's have a look. Let's check my addictions. Ah, lovely. Strength plus one from spineless, stealth suit, water breathing, and well rested. Okay. Maybe I should replace my body parts.
You require some addition.
Okay, here we go. Swap body parts. Oh, let's install the implants, shall we, and see if they do anything above. They didn't look particularly useful. I'll swap body parts. Select organ to replace. Associated perks will also be replaced. Right. Do I want to place my heart back in my chest or reattach my spine? Oh, my spine's giving me plus one, so maybe I'll. Plus one strength, so maybe I'll keep that in. Let's put my heart back. Cardiac arrest perk. Your heart is back in your body, but some advanced technologies remain. You're less resistant to poison, 50%, and robots are only somewhat confused by you, 25% less likely to score a critical hit. But now, on the bright side, healing items and chems are twice as effective. Well, I like that.
Bad guys dealt with.
Seems like a fair trade. Now let's check what happens when I get my spine back just quickly, because I can reload and just skip back through and make sure. Oh, I can just put them back in and out. Okay, that's fine. Your spine is back in your body, but some advanced technologies remain. Your torso can now be crippled again, but your strength and damage threshold bonuses have doubled. Plus two. Nice. So let's take a look at my statisticals and see what we've got. Reinforced spine, strength plus two, which was more than I had before. That's lovely, isn't it? I'm not irradiated. I'm fully healed. Oh, I love this little thing. It's fantastic. What's my financial position? 22,480. Let's sell some gear, if this guy's got any money, of course.
Might I be of service, sir?
Yes, you might. Switch off the sink's personality matrices. Ah, that doesn't seem like a good thing to do. I like my C-3PO shop. I need my equipment.
Very good.
Give you a bit more money. Still suit needs repairing. Jesus, that thing's expensive to repair. So's that. Ouch. Whoa, spending a lot of money there. Let's trade. I'd like to buy some things, or rather sell some things. What have we got? Weapons. Proton axe, Dr. Mobius' glove. What was really expensive before? I don't think I need the X2 antenna. It's a hand-to-hand weapon, for goodness sake. Why would I use it? Proton axe. Let's do the fully repaired one. 4,000. Accept. How much has he got left? 1,432. And so another proton axe. Good. He's down to 224. Oh my god, that thing's worth a fortune. The Valence Radii Accentuator. Health regeneration, endurance plus one. Let's put it on. And the combat armor, should we put that on? Oh wait, shit, I just sold it. Cancel transaction. Yes, okay, that's a good idea. Let's put the thing on first. Items. Paddle. I look fairly snazzy in that. I appear to have lost all my hair, but oh well. Probably a result of my cranial extraction. Right, now seems like a good time to save and head in and talk to the think tank. Hello, think tank. Dr. Klein awaits. Make sure you're prepared to finish this once and for all. Okay, let's check my stats quickly, see if I should bother popping some mentats or anything. Intelligence 7. Let's get some mentats down me. Or in fact, I could just put on Dr. Klein's thingy. I don't intend to fight him, do I? Let's put Dr. Mobius' scrubs on. That's plus 2 intelligence.
Did I do something wrong?
Which means intelligence 9. We'll neck some mentats just in case. There we go. Let's get in and clash brains with these guys. Hey, how you doing, Dr. Klein?
The lobotomite returns. Our lobotomite. Has Dr. Mobius been denominated into scrap metal and voice module parts, as we hoped?
Interesting. I found my brain. Now you and I are going to settle things. I think you are past due for your lobotomy, Klein. You may have noticed the pacification field is down. Guess what happens now? Okay.
I recommend watching your tone with me, lobotomite. Now, your brain. Hand it over, or we'll extract it again.
I'm not handing my brain over. There are some things we should discuss. I think you're past due for your lobotomy, Klein. You may have noticed blah blah.
And what could we possibly have to speak about? You have the brain, we have the technology. All you must do is surrender. With it, we can finally leave this place. I cannot tell you how boring this place gets, chopping up the landscape and everything in it. And we have so many questions to ask your brain first. About this Mojave place. A fertile testing ground for our experiments.
Okay, let's take a look at our option here. Lie. You think I am the lobotomite? No, for my skull houses the brain of Mobius. Mobius and I talked it over, reached an understanding. Maybe you should confer with your colleagues first. I can't let you dissect the Mojave, or let you leave. I think you're past due for your lobotomy, Klein. Okay, let's try this speech one.
That is the most insane thing I've ever heard. There's no way Mobius would condescend to step inside you. Besides, there's no way such a thing could be accomplished. It's impossible.
Alright, let's blind him with science, shall we? Nothing is impossible for science. Mesons, lasers, atoms, brainwaves, all are at my command.
You speak the truth. And the decibel variation in your voice. It is Mobius. How dare you breach the think tank? And what do you want here?
He offered you a deal. I offer you a deal. Stay here, stay put, and I'll let you live. That's the one.
That's no deal at all. There's a whole world beyond the crater, filled with ideas and possibilities. We could have escaped, seen it all for ourselves, tested it, prodded at it, made it squirm.
Okay, I will permit you to do this for me.
Partner with you, my foe, my rival, my foremost critic? I have a strange sensation that I would like that. How odd. Very well, partner. The think tank is at your service as long as you do not destroy us.
It looks like I avoided any particular combat. Nice. Now I spoke to you, though. Please could I have my brain back? Will you put it back in?
Thank you for what you have done. The helping, that is. We like that. I feel an odd emotion. Gratitude? Attitude? No, wait. Gratitude. That's it.
Okay. No more new things to talk about. Let's see who else we can talk to. Who can put my brain back in? I think it was... what was her name? Darla? No, Dr. Boris. Ah, here she is over here. If I recall correctly.
The teddy bear lobotomite returns. My teddy bear. How can I assist in relieving your curiosity?
Alright, looks like we've already,
Until our next...
Okay. It looks like they haven't got some new any new dialogue, so we'll head back out of here. Go back to the sink, and hopefully we'll be able to leave Big Mountain for good. Well, not for good, hopefully we'll be able to come back and return as we please, because that auto dock's going to be incredibly useful.
As it had been the years before the Great War, Big Mountain, the Big Empty, became home to one of the brightest minds of the 23rd century. The courier watched over the Big Empty for years to come, caring for it, and keeping its discoveries safe until they were needed to help others. Which had always been Big Mountain's purpose. Past the laboratories and science, it had always been intended as a place to build the future of all mankind.
The courier had scoured much of the Big Empty, although secrets still remained in the crater's depths. Perhaps that was for the best, however. Curiosity, while sometimes rewarded for its efforts, often proves to be equally dangerous.
Dr. Mobius continued his research undisturbed in the Forbidden Zone. As much as he had attempted to create better scorpions, he tried the same with humanity, with considerably less success. These failures didn't bother him overmuch. Once the rush of Mentats wore off, he forgot he had failed in any event. After all, the bright young mind who had come to visit him in the Forbidden Zone had already exceeded his expectations.
The sink was strangely silent, which it had never been in previous years. The lack of personality modules made the base lifeless and sterile.
Autodoc, always gentle and methodical, kept sewing up the courier in all the right places when the skin split open from repeated wear and tear. The Autodoc was just glad to have purpose again. It heard its simpler brothers and sisters who got shipped to the Sierra Madre, or bored out of their skulls in that toxic dead city. In time, the Autodoc found a way to deactivate the Y-17 trauma harnesses, releasing the corpses they had held prisoner for almost 200 years.
As the courier ran through the X-8 facility multiple times, the computers analyzed the test subject's movements. Rather than performing a superficial observation, they realized the subject barely knew what communism was, or even what a high school was. This confused them for a time, until the facility finally realized that its research had succeeded. So it let its cyber dogs out into the wastes to help protect small communities from physical aggression rather than communist propaganda.
The infiltration program in X-13 continued to scan for the subject and the stealth suit prototype long after the test was over. Frustrated and unable to find its lost technology, X-13 expanded its network of laser tripwires, sensors, and robo-brains out across Big Mountain. This glittering blue light beam forest cleanly bisected anything that entered its depths, slicing them into small segmented parts for easy disposal.
The courier, organs intact, continued onwards, a little less heavy of step, but with all the organs in the right places, as they should be. After all, brains can develop a life of their own when left to their own thoughts, and the courier's brain was more clever than most.
Dr. Klein and the think tank remained alive, unaware of the world outside. They looped through their daily routine, none the wiser about the world beyond, although perhaps wiser was the wrong word. The world outside belonged to the courier, and if anyone would shape it, well, the courier had already called dibs.
There is an expression in the wasteland, old world blues.
It refers to those so obsessed with the past they can't see the present, much less the future, for what it is.
They stare into the what was, eyes like pilot lights, guttering and spent, as the realities of their world continue on around them.
Science is a long, steady progression into the future. What may seem a sudden event often isn't felt for years, even centuries to come.
In the times following the Second Battle of Hoover Dam, however, old world blues took on a new meaning.
Where once it was viewed as a form of sadness, nostalgia, it became an expression describing the potential for the future.
It can be easy to see science as evil, technology unchecked as the source of all ills, all misfortunes.
With the courier at the helm, science became a beacon for the future. There was old world blues and new world hope. And hope ruled the day at Big Mountain.
We could say more, but the stories in the Big Empty speak for themselves. Now armed with the transportal ponder, the courier could return to the dome at any time and crack open the secrets of the Big Empty one by one. The Sink sat vigilant, waiting for its master to return, shoes covered in Mojave dust. Only one road yet remained, and it was one the courier had to walk alone.
Right, there you go. We've lost the brainless perk. Gained the big-brained perk. The big-brained perk. Your brain is back in your body, but some of the advanced technologies remain. Your head still cannot be crippled, but you are only 10% more resistant to addiction now. Surprisingly, your damage threshold is improved by 10%, minimum plus 1 DT. Pardon me. You've acquired the Big Mountain Transportal Ponder. It's capable of transporting you and you alone between the Mojave Wasteland and Big Mountain. To return to the Mojave or go back to Big Mountain from the Mojave, simply equip the transportal ponder as you would any weapon, pull the trigger, and away you'll go. Note that it won't work in interiors or in combat situations, and is totally incapable of harming your enemies.
Huzzah, sir! Huzzah! Huzzah, sir!
Herons! 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 Herons!
Okay, so I'm all healed up. Have you got any more
Might
money?
Might I be safe in the assumption that matters with the think tank have been satisfactorily concluded vis-a-vis your residence in this domicile?
Yes, you can conclude that. Should I turn off his personality matrices? That doesn't seem like a good idea. Let's give it a go, though, why not?
Very good indeed, sir. Throwing out the riffraff protocols engaged. All personality matrices are offline, sir. Very good, sir.
Right, let's have a little look. He's only got 224 caps. No good.
Will
let's turn them back on.
For any considerable length of time during sir's visit? Do you, sir? Well, if that is sir's wish.
Right, is there anything else I can talk to in here before I go? Okay. Oh, no, there isn't. Let's get this transportal ponder out and finally get our ass out of here. Weapons? Oh, big mountain transportal ponder. Here we go. Dude. What do you mean it won't function on the interior? Damn you! I know I just read that out loud, I should know it, but... Ah! Look at this. Though they were a powerful force in the West decades ago, the Enclave has not been seen or heard from in the Mojave Wasteland for years. Ah! Bah! Oh, I'm not wearing my armor either. That seems like a poor choice. Let's get my apparel and we'll put on this combat armor for now because why not? Don't I look just splendid? Okay, let's have a look at the quests. Data. Oh, where are we gone? Okay, we go to the Brotherhood of Steel and return that audio book thing they had. You know what? I'm not going to follow a quest. I'm just going to go straight to Vegas again. Oh my god, I got that perk that uncovers the entire map. Good lord. So much stuff. Now I can no longer find the strip. Here we go. Let's get up to the strip, shall we? Okay guys, I know I've been gone for a while, but look at me now. I am rock hard. What have we got? Stats. I am now level 23. I believe I've gone up quite a few levels since I was last here. Anyone attempting to kill me will be summarily executed. Eliminated. Okay. Taking a while to walk down here, but you can probably guess where I'm going. I'm heading off to the energy weapons store. Because they can probably buy some of this expensive stuff off me. No problem. There we go, a little bit of a whistle for you.
We're watching you.
Yeah, watch away. I just want to sell some shit.
Welcome back. I hope you've been working on that task Jean-Baptiste had for you. My brother is not a patient man by any means.
I've got no idea where that woman is.
Please let me know if... Welcome back.
Whoa. I'd like to see what you have to say. That's what we wanted. Okay. Right, let's go to my weapons. Dr. Mobius' glove can be sold. What, she's only got 318 caps? Good grief. Let's see what we can buy off of her. Anything exciting? Weapons. Cleansing flame. Incinerator, laser pistol, laser rifle, plasma defender, blah blah blah, plasma rifle. The Smitty special. Whoa, I can't even afford it. There's some expensive stuff in this game. Okay, let's have a look at what else they've got. Miscellaneous. Ammo box, baseball bat, cork core. Baseball bat, maple body. Drained microfusion cell, extended flamer tanks, Gatling laser focus optics, katana protective sheath, laser rifle focus optics. These are all updates, I see. Increases ammunition capacity, plus 24%, That's quite a cool one, actually. Tri-beam LRHD caps increases condition 200%. Okay, ammo. Well, I don't need to buy any ammo. I've got tons of stuff. And that's it. Okay, I thought you would be a better shop. I'm off. Bye. I know you're watching me. Okay, I don't think I've got any quests to hand in here. Or with the kings, so let's just fast travel up the other end of the strip. That makes more sense, doesn't it? No, that was the wrong place. I want to go to the strip north gate. There we go. And we're in. Let's head back. Maybe it's time to take over from Mr. House. Maybe, maybe not. We shall see. Has this guy got any money left? I remember him selling holdout weapons. He could be a
back again?
Fairly rich guy.
Need a weapon for an emergency. Mr. Holdout's your guy.
I can get weapons past the guards, no problem.
You might. One fella I knew was able to slip a pistol past the guards. You? I'm guessing you could get a machine gun by them.
I probably could. Why would I need to hide a weapon on me? Let's see what he has.
Take a look.
310 caps. Okay. There's not really anything I can sell to him that would be worth it. Okay, what are we looking for out here? Oh, there's the guy that I'm supposed to have killed.
Hey!
Hey! There's the lucky 38. I don't want to go in there just yet. Do I have any missions around here? Let's have a look at the map. Perhaps. What's this mission marker? The Repcon headquarters. Okay, let's have a look at this quest again and see what we're doing. All my friends have off switched. Okay, this is a quest that's not for this map, so. I could talk to the Yes Man. Tell him I'm familiar with the Brotherhood of Steel. Birds of a Feather. Where do I find Rose of Sharon Cassidy? Nowhere, apparently. Could sell back Caccino's journal. Let's do that. If I have to shoot my way out of a casino, who gives a shit? Before I sacrifice my weapons, though, I think I will save the game quickly.
No one but Omertas are allowed to carry. You'll get these.
What weapons have I got? Have they taken all my weapons? Ha! No. Well, most of my weapons. Okay. Not Seneca Meta Revelation, though. Okay, let's go back to Carlito. If I remember correctly, he was in Infernos.
Holy shit, you've been in Lucky 38? You mean the overboss in there?
Brimstone, that was it, not Infernos. That's an entirely different place. If indeed a place at all. He was over here, if I remember correctly. Yeah, there he is.
Hey, hey, look who it is! My best buddy!
I'd like to talk to you about your journal.
Yeah, I hope you're looking to do some business with me. I think it could be mutually beneficial.
Is this journal worth 100 caps to you? Who could I show it to? That was the other option, wasn't it? I could show it to someone.
I can pay you for it, of course. Between you and I, we can break up what they're planning. Maybe save some lives. Mine included, of course.
Sounds good to me.
Oh, here's some caps. Now give me the journal. Right, there we go. So let me tell you what I know about the family's business. The bosses, Big Sal and Nero, have been working for a while on this. They're arming themselves like an army, using this new guy, Troik. They also brought in a specialist named Clandon. At least that's what they introduced him as.
Okay, what kind of specialist is Clandon?
I got no fucking idea. They let him have the run of the place, though. He seems like a nice guy, but he makes me nervous. He's a little arrogant, but he's too nice. Too open. I've never seen him fucking or gambling. Everyone has a vice, but this guy seems like the Pope.
Okay, I have a couple more questions.
Okay, toss them at me.
Tell me about this Troik.
He's a skittish little fucker. Spends half the day pumping his body full of chems and the other half pumping hookers with his willy. He has some kind of connections, so he's able to smuggle huge shipments of weapons into the Strip. The bosses got him by the short hairs. We covered up a hooker he killed while flying on some psycho, so he gets us guns in exchange for not ratting.
Sounds like a wonderful deal. That's all the questions I have. Actually, let's ask some more questions. Do you know anything about what they're planning?
No, just that it involves guns and muscle. Also that it's big. Very big. Only Nero and Big Saul know everything, and they ain't telling.
Okay, that's all the questions I have for now. Thank you very much.
You can find me here or upstairs in my room. I'll let the muscle know you're a friend of mine. That should let you get around a little easier.
Nice. Good. Okay, does that mean we can go through this locked door that got me in so much trouble before? Yes, it does. Ah, a little bit of exploration. That'll go down a treat. Ooh, pool tables upstairs. That's a little bit disappointing, seeing as they're not actually interactive. I can't play pool, but whatever. Big Sal. Yeah, Omerta Thud.
Hey, you're Cuccino's friend. You got business with me?
What kind of business do you do here? Mick and Ralph are curious why you stopped buying guns from them.
Sorry, but I don't know you from Adam. And you don't have any business getting in our business.
What kind of business do you do here?
We run a hotel. What do you think our business is?
Okay, goodbye.
Alright, come back any time.
Yeah, I won't. It's going to have to be a pretty substantial fight to get through to him and kill him. Let's have a look and see what else we've got. Yeah.
The fuck are you looking at?
Gamora Cash Room Guard.
I got kicked out of Ultralux the other day. Man, that place gives me the fucking freaks. I'm glad they don't let just any motherfucker through the gate. Freeside smells like shit.
I'm going to try something. Gonna try and sneak myself into the cash room. Not gonna work. He doesn't have a key. Ah, oh, very hard. Boo. Boo. I really wanted to break into there. It's not fair. Doors of the Gamora lower lobby. There's a Gamora laughs. Troik.
Who are you? I didn't do anything. Leave me alone.
Alright, you prostitute murderer. Fess up. Cuccino sent to ask me about you some guns.
Cuccino? Cuccino what? Are you kidding me? He must be trying to get me killed.
I'm looking to help Cuccino break up whatever the bosses are planning. Let's talk about something else. What do you do here?
I don't see how that's your business. I'm just a guest here, having a little fun.
My ass. Tell me what happened with the prostitute.
Oh, man. I don't even like to think about it. All that goddamn blood. It was just in the hotel, like any other night. I took some chems with the girl I was with, but I never black out. I did this time, though. Next thing I knew, I woke up, she was lying next to me, stabbed dead. There was a knife next to the bed, and I was covered in her blood.
Do you know where the knife came from?
I keep a little switchblade tucked away with me. You never know when you might find some trouble.
I have a couple of more questions about what happened that night. I don't think he did it, otherwise I wouldn't be asking all these questions.
All right, have at it.
What kind of chems were you doing?
That night? Mostly buff out. I like to cut it with a little bit of jet and wash it down with some whiskey. That was my standard Saturday night.
That seems like a lot of chems. Right. dear. Not enough medicine. Boo.
Like I said, pretty standard for me. I can handle my shit.
All right. That's it for now. Okay, so Troik's an interesting character. Got prostitute issues. Oh god, I really need to get some more lockpick skills. Oh, hello. Goodbye. I'm gonna go down the stairs in here and see what's what. What will I find in this lower level of the casino? Another room full of pillows. Brilliant.
Welcome back to Gamora. Find yourself a girl or a guy and have a drink. Your family.
Whatever. Shut up. Just a regular Omerta thug here. Oh, wow. I've got a much easier run of the place now. Let's actually talk to this guy. He may not have a name, but he's got a title.
Fuck not at home. Be cozy up there in the Lucky 38.
That's a strange little dance. Okay, okay.
God damn,
where are we now? Let's, we've got to come back and figure out how to get into that cash room. The name is just too tempting. What's this? Okay, we're still in the back area. Call express elevator to suites. Okay, cool. I thought that was someone sitting in a desk there. Or sitting in the chair, rather. Ah, sitting on a cushion. Lovely. Let's get up. This is a smoky room, isn't it? What's going on in here?
Find yourself a girl or a guy. Have some fun.
Clamden, I've heard your name.
Hey, nice to meet you. Do you need help with something?
What do you do around here?
A little bit of this and a little bit of that.
Specific. How did you end up with one of the hotel suites?
I'm a close friend of some of the family around here. I do some independent contracting around the casino, and they set me up with this great room.
Interesting. Cacino sent me to talk to you.
Cacino? Yeah, I've heard the name. Not sure why he'd send you to me. Is he helping out with room service or something?
Goodbye.
See.
Okay, Clandon, you seem a bit weird. I'm going to save and try and pickpocket you, see if you've got any interesting guff in your pockets. Hidden. Ooh, detected hidden. He's got his room key. I can try taking that. Let's do it. He didn't even notice. Boom! Look at that. Oh, Clandon, you nincompoop. Haha, I'm going to go in your room, which is probably that one down there, isn't it? Oh well. Ooh, looks a little bit gaudy. Excuse me, Clandon.
The tower on the strip, the one you can see for miles? I hear it ain't sealed up no more.
Whoa. Blood all over the shop. Okay. Don't know what's going on here. Let's try the next room. Restrooms. Jesus, there's blood and flies everywhere. This is really quite a grim place. I lost karma! Oh, I didn't know. I didn't realise this kind of criminality would be punished. I wouldn't have done it if I'd known. Right, we've got to find Clandon's room. He's clearly not in here anywhere.
You seen that tower on the strip all lit up? I can see it for miles.
Okay, let's get in here. Pardon me. Okay, this is weird. Just a little dead end down here. Whatever. Okay, so is this Clandon's room? Didn't say use key. Is this your... It's There's got to be some weirdness about Clandon, right? Whatever, you keep hearing about stuff, that's cool, whatever. Maybe I am in Clandon's room? Maybe I'm not. Doesn't look like it. Most of the bedrooms won't have a double door, will they? And this is a suite. Elevators, let's ignore that. Go over this side, see what we find. Okay. Need to pick it. No can do. There's the elevators. More grim blood. Express elevator to lower level. Elevator. There's got to be something more here. Surely. What have we got in here?
Welcome back to Gamora. Find yourself a girl or a guy and have a drink. Your family.
Shut up. I'm only interested in exploring here for the loot and the possible plot options. Well, Clandon seems to be a bit of a weirdo. This woman is dead. Would you like to inspect her to see if you can get more information? Medicine 35 or higher required. Let's inspect. You take a look at the body, but are unable to determine anything about the cause or nature of her death aside from the knife wounds. I'm stealing from a fucking psychopathic murderer. Surely that's not worth the loss of karma. Surely. Okay, regardless. It looks like this is the prostitute killer, not the other guy. Ah! Maybe I'll just go and talk to him about the prostitute. He does seem to have a lot of blood knocking around though. These guys must know. Clearly they know. He's in a casino. They must be watching his room. Hey, Clandon. Oh, he's not Clandon. Which way is it? This way? Yeah, this is the room he was in. Where are you, Clandon? Hey, I want to ask you about the dead prostitute in your room.
Good to see you again. Hope you're winning some money in here.
What?
Goodbye.
I can't confront him. Nonsense. Quit. Over the edge. Let's do it. Let's take the express elevator to the lower levels.
Welcome back.
Cool. We're in the lower levels. Ah, boo. It's the boring lower levels. It's the bit we've already been in. So the elevator's just suites. So what's this elevator? Stay here, lower brimstone, main level. Boo. Okay, we'll come back and explore this place later. First of all, I'm going to leave. Or am I? Because I'm going the wrong way. Pretty sure I'm going the wrong way. That's the door over there. Off to the door we go, go, go. Outside we must be, ho, ho. Right, that's all my weapons were given back. Yay, look at me. My bald head after
Please
my...
Stand in the fountains.
Do what? What's fancy our troopers? Nice. And hookers. Nice. Maybe I can talk my way past, actually looking at the time, starting a brand new quest line probably wouldn't make much sense. I'm going to have to stop soon. Let's go and have a little look around elsewhere. We haven't been to the Ultralux very much. They've got the high rollers there, haven't they? Of course there's Vault 21 as well. Did I do everything there? And this is the place with the shows, right? Let's have a look in the Ultralux. Alright, calm down. It's only a fence. A fence? A fountain. Weirdness. Hello, Ultralux. Where was the Yes Man again? I forget.
Beg your pardon, but could I trouble you to turn over your weapons?
My deepest apologies for the slightest inconvenience.
You have my assurance that everything will be returned upon your departure. But we simply can't have anyone waving their weapons around in the hotel. It's not the atmosphere we wish to cultivate. Please, enjoy your stay.
You seem shady.
They'll be handled with the utmost security in our bank.
Okay, whatever. I'm gonna enjoy killing you. What weapons he got there? He's carrying a cane. Right, learn about the white gloves by talking to the leaders. I could do that. Or we could explore and see who's here. Gamblers. Gunderson hired hand.
Howdy.
Heck Gunderson. Why does that name ring a bell? Someone must have told me about him. Ah, there's a roulette wheel. Can we play roulette? No, we don't have any chips. Another gambler. Gambler, what about the bar staff? I know the strip's all stirred up. I've been stirring it. We can play blackjack, white glove. Okay, I'm not seeing where to get my chips. Must be round here, I imagine. Ah, there we go, the cashier. This place is rather fancy, isn't it?
Hello there.
Yeah, whatever.
Morning.
It's quite fancy pants, isn't it? Gambler. 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 Mortimer. Okay, you just look creepy, mate. I'm not going to talk to you yet. We'll have words later on. How about you? Chauncey. Interesting name. Doesn't look particularly healthy, though. Got a very yellowish tint to him. Gomorrah Hotel's unique style, Las Vegas, Nevada. Door to the Gourmand at the Ultralux. The Gourmand. Marjorie. Hello, Marjorie. A nice little dining room. Lovely. Okay, well, I think I've explored this place enough. I'm going to head outside and then I'm going to end the stream. Bathhouse? My goodness, this place has it all, doesn't it? Baths, food, I imagine they have toilets, gambling, all you could possibly want under one roof. I'm going to dance all over their stupid card tables. And out we go. Okay, time to save and time to end the stream. The stream comes to a close. Why'd I do that? There we go. Thank you for watching, YouTubers. I'm going to get rid of you now. Get rid of you. I'm going to stop recording now. And then no doubt you'll see the next one. See you later. Bye. Subscribe, like, do all that stuff. Bye. Bye.